What it do, YouTube? My name is JJ. I don't even know where to start with this. So I'm trying to get the PS5, and I sold. I literally had the PS5 in my cart, in my hands, ready to go, and I sold. It feels bad, man. I have a tip for everybody out there trying to get a PS5 right now with this whole Walmart crisis going on. And this is not what the video is going to be about. I'm just going to say this real quick and we're going to get right into what y'all really came here for. Make sure you put RD, like road, at the end of your address. That's all I'm gonna say. If you don't have that in your address, they will tell you that your address is wrong, and they'll literally just toy with you in the cart, and before you even fix it, sold out. PS5 is gone. So I will be trying again at 3 p.m. Hopefully I can get one then. I came super close, so I have high hopes that I will. But with that all being said, let's get right into the video. So you all came here, all you Wang players out there, came here to learn how to dribble. Learn some advanced combos and glitchy moves. And right now you see I'm on my floor general, but I'm going to show you my favorite Wang build. I like to call this my Kobe build. So it's a Wang score, 6'6", lowest weight. And if we go to my attributes, if you're watching this right now, you know, hit that like button for me. Like button is a prayer for JJShott to get a PS5, because right now it's PS5 me, please. I want a PS5 bad, you know what I mean? I've been waiting for this. So as you can see, this is my build. I have a 95 dribbling with this build. And like I said in my last video, same thing, my floor general, I have a 95 dribbling. So some of these combos that I'm going to be showing you, if you don't have a 95 dribbling, you might not be able to do. And don't quote me on this, but you might have to be at least an 88, I'm not sure. But I have 95 dribbling, so that would allow me to get these done. Let me level up my icon. I didn't even know I had that option. I really don't play on this build like that, as you can see. But yeah, I use this build when I feel like just dunking on people, because this is that all-purpose build. Like, you can do, you dribble, shoot, dunk on people, post fades, play good defense. Like, for those people that want that all-purpose build and want to sacrifice just a little bit of speed, this is the build for you. So the dribble animations that I use is Kevin Durant level 2. I use this specifically because it has the best wide crossover. But if you don't need that wide crossover, you can always go James Harden level 2. And I believe I don't have Damian Lillard level 2. But if you do have that, that's definitely a good dribble package you could also use. But yeah, this is for my wings. So Kevin Durant level 2, that's what I use. And the jump shot again that I use is Chris Paul's jump shot, and I explained why I use that in my last video. I use this for the step backs and the snatch back, which push a defender on the ground. This jump shot will give you that. So with all that being said, let's head over to the one court and let's get this tutorial popping. Alright, so we're in our court. Let me loosen up a little bit because I haven't dribbled on this building forever. But as you can see, you know, I do this. But yeah, so the moves I'm gonna be teaching you with this build is your bread and butter combo, which is that right there. Boom. This right here is a killer, super hard to guard. You can even, if I remember how to do it, you can even, if you could get a crossover. I don't remember how to do it, but there's a way where you can do this move right here, but you can do it like running away from the hoop. and it looks real glitchy. I forget how to do it, but once you learn these combos, you'll probably figure it out yourself. And if I ever do come back to play NBA Live, if I figure it out, I can just make an update video, whatever, on how to do it. But yeah, to do that better combo, I gotta teach you how to do this right here. It's kind of like reminds me of like behind the back 16 from 2K20, you know, that broken behind the back move. This move right here is a killer, because look how much space you're creating, you know what I mean, and you're running at the hoop, and it's also a pretty useful tactic you can use to get an open three. And you can green those too. Another thing I love about this build is you can green drifters. I don't shoot drifters like that, but you can green them. You can see the green right there. Matter of fact, I can't give up on. There you go. You can also hit post, I believe. If I hit a post shot, you can green those. Like, this is literally Kobe. Like, this build is literally the Kobe build. You can dunk. You can dunk on people pretty frequently with this build. And on top of that, you can dribble. So, next move I'm going to be teaching you guys is the wide crossover into the spin. You're going to need to know how to do that. Now, this is a little bit different than how the point guard wide crossover spin works. The way you do it is exactly the same, you know, running wide crossover into a spin move, but look how she's spinning. She's not spinning at the hoop, she's kind of spinning to the side more, you know what I mean? Like, she's spinning like around, and you'll see why it works very well with the combo that I'm going to teach you, the bread and butter combo. Another move. I also use, for whatever reason, I can't whoop the I can't freaking whoop the in my one court, but I with this build you can whoop the in game. I don't know why I can't whoop the, or it might be because I'm using Kevin Durant. If you want to whoop the, if you don't know what the whoop the is, that's the you know, the behind the back fake where they're about to go behind the back, but they keep it in the same ball hand, and they kind of do like a, it's like a little dance move with it, you know what I mean? That right there, you might have to use James Harden for that, but if you're gonna use James Harden, you're sacrificing this move right here, the wide crossover. Now, this right here is like, personally, I feel like this is the best wide crossover in the game, Kevin Durant's, because you can stop so much faster to the point where you can almost like spam it. It's pretty nuts. See what I mean? And yeah, so let's get into this tutorial. So the bread and butter combo. Well, before I get into the bread and butter combo, I'm gonna teach you these two dribble moves. So first I'm gonna talk about, I'm gonna just call it behind the back 16, cause I don't know what else to call it in this game, or the glitchy behind the back. So this is a running behind the back. So you're going to be walking forward, and you're going to do a wide between the legs while you're walking forward. You should get that animation. Do it again. This animation right here. Once you get that animation, you're just going to throw behind the back in there. And when you're doing this move, you're not holding R2 at all. You just run up, boom, behind the back to the off ball hand, you get the animation. You get me? And again, if you're not running fully straight, you'll get this animation. Know what I mean? So, now that you got that move down, let me do it one more time. Wide between the legs, behind the back. And you don't have to hold the wide that long. Like, you can cancel out of the wide as fast as you want. That should be pretty smooth with it too. See that? I like to go wide just a little bit so it kind of looks like I'm about to go one direction and I go the other direction. Kind of gets your opponent guarding you, you know, kind of keeps them on their heels like they don't know what you're about to do. Boom. And yeah, that's that behind the back 16, glitchy behind the back, whatever you want to call it. Next move I'm going to be teaching you is the wide crossover into the spin move. So same thing as before, except you're not doing wide between the legs. You're going to be holding R2 this whole time. So before, you're not holding R2. All right, I'm back. I had to take care of something real quick. Yeah, so like I was saying, same motion as the wide crossover or the wide between the legs behind the back, but you're holding R2 the whole time. So you're going to get the wide crossover spin move. See, super easy. You do this going up the court, and you can set you up for open three. Like, this move right here is pretty glitchy. It's, you know what I'm saying? It's super exaggerated. Like, look how much space I'm creating right there. Like, let's say they don't expect you to do that and they're just gonna stand still or whatever. You're right here. You know what I mean? That was deep. That was not supposed to go in. But, you know what I mean? Like, you can get it, like, let me see if I can get it right at the 3-point line. Nah, but it's kind of hard to set up like this in the one court because it's so small. But yeah, see it right there, like it's pretty deadly, and you can like wide crossover out of it and stuff like that. What's the next move I'm gonna be teaching you? A matter of fact, I taught my point guards how to do the glitchy hezzy, the turnaround hezzy. So I'm gonna teach you guys too. So there's two ways you can do this. I'm gonna teach you the first way. This is a combo starter. You know, I use this to start combo. So with the ball on my left hand or right hand, as long as you're going to the left, run back. And then while they're gonna drop the ball and try to turn all the way around. In the middle of them turning around, like right here, see how she's throwing the ball to her off-ball hand? Right when she's about to throw the ball to her off-ball hand, you're gonna flick up. And you're holding R2 the whole time. Just hold R2 the whole time. Boom. See? Walk off to the left. Run back, flick up. Now, this is Blackie GH's move. The way he does it, I still can't do it. He goes to the right. Maybe if you're, it might be because you have a left-handed shooter, maybe, I'm not sure. But yeah, some people can go to the right with this. I still can't see. I only get the animation, so I go to the left because that's what works for me consistently. I can pretty much do it every time. You can even do a hezzy out of it. You see that, like before, instead of doing like the wide crossover and going into it, you could just hezzy and go into it. You can also do a wide between the legs into it, do a wide behind the back into it. As long as you're going to the left, doesn't matter what you do, as long as you're going to the left and you try to turn around with it and get this animation, you can do the glitchy hezzy. Very simple. So again, going left, I'm trying to run back, so I'm, you know, shoving my left wrist stick down and I'm flicking up with the right stick. And then to spin out of it, because let's say you just hold down the whole time, they'll just do this. To spin out of it, you know, you just kind of rotate your joystick to which way you want to run. So if I want to run diagonal left, you get the animation. If I want to run diagonal right, you get the animation. This right here catches a lot of ankles when you drop the ball and turn it around. And I even talk about this in my last tutorial. You can even fake it like you're about to go diagonal left and then go back right. You feel me? So boom, go diagonal left and then come back this way. You feel me? You'll really catch a lot of ankles with that. The second way to do this, so just like I taught in my guard triple tutorial, the bread and butter. So if you don't know how to spin back, I talked about my basic tutorials. Go watch that. The spin back is basically just running in certain angles and then just trying to run backwards, and you do spin back. See, I call this the NBA Live version of the Steezel roll, because it's the same way you do the Steezel roll. It's the same thing. And I mean the Steve O'Rourke from NBA 2K20, if any of you guys are confused with that and don't know where that came from, but I'm pretty sure all of y'all know where that came from if you're watching this video. So what you're going to do is, once you get good at doing the spin back, you're going to spin back into a spin move. This is the starter of your bread and butter combo too, so you want to get this down. Spin back, spin move. So you want the ball when you spin back in your left hand, because if it's in your right hand and you spin back, now you got to go the opposite direction. You get me? See, if I go with my right hand, boom. Sometimes you can't even spin move out of that if you're going the wrong way. See, you'll get that animation. That animation is kind of wonky. It's going to take you all over the place. And it's actually a good setup, actually, if you do that move. If you kind of like, let me see if I can do it again. It's kind of hard to get. It's not consistent at all for me. Cannot do it. Hold on. Get it. If I could do it right here, no. All right, one more try, and then I'm gonna just move on, because this video is about to be long enough as it is. Yeah, see, it's super. I'm trying to spin move the wrong way. You'll see what I'm talking about in a minute, but forget it. We'll come back to that. So while the ball is in your player's right hand like this, see how the ball is in the right hand? You're going to spin move to the right side of your screen. So you're going to go from 3 o'clock and rotate from 6 to 9. So you're basically just going to rotate 3 to 9, and then you should get something like this. Now, when you run up against the wall, of course, you're not going to get the clean animation. You get the animation. So once you get it down, you go into spin back, and you get the clean spin move. You see what I mean? Hold on, one more time. Boom. Look, spin back, spin move. And when you do the spin move, it's gonna send you running to the right side of your screen. So that's when you could throw in the glitchy hezzy. So to do the glitchy hezzy, you do spin move, let go of everything, and flick up. See? Spin move, let go of everything, flick up. You could also flick left. Flicking left works too. But you can flick up also. I mean, as long as it's doing the hezzy. So yeah, now that we're in our bread and butter, so I'm gonna teach you guys the bread and butter combo, which is this. And I know that looks crazy, but it's super duper easy. So with this combo, you kind of want to be ways behind the three-point line. Because you're going to be, when you do the glitchy behind the back, it's going to pull you all the way in towards the hoop. So you kind of don't want to do it right here. Because see, that gives you no space to do like a clean spin move. Like I said, they're waiting for you in the paint. That's easy steal. So you kind of want to come out here and do it. Now you got room to do your spin move. And you can even fake out of that. Like let's say you wanted to do a spin back after that. Boom, 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 boom. Something like that. That would have been green in game, but yeah, so once you get that, and again, you're gonna do spin back, crossover 16 to spin move. Behind the back 16 to a wide spin move. So boom, or crossover spin move every time. What else is there? So you can even, I don't think you could do the glitchy hezzy out of that, but let's say you do glitchy hezzy and then you decide to spin the other direction. Let me see. Same plan. And once you learn all of these moves, like, you're gonna find other combos and stuff that'll work for you. Probably stuff I haven't even thought of. But I'm just teaching you the base dribble moves. You know, you take these dribble moves and do what you want with them. You know what I mean? The way I do them might not be the way that's most efficient for you. You know what I mean? Like, it's all about experimenting. It's like playing a fighting game, bro. Like, you put combos together. You know, there's always those bread and butter combos. But there's some combos, like the pros and stuff that play Mortal Kombat. You know what I mean? Like, they do combos that's most efficient for them, and probably like combos that if they was to use with like Katana, you probably won't do the same combo with Katana, but you can find a better combo that's more efficient for you that does about the same damage. You know what I mean? Boom. All right. You also got your, call these like the walk back, moonwalks right here. You can use these as a setup. And like I said in my last video, with your bread and butter combo, it's very important that you learn how to go both directions. I taught you how to go this way with it and stuff like that. You kind of want to learn how, not kind of, you're going to need to if you want to be as, you know, deadly as possible. You want to learn how to do it both ways, so I can go both ways with it. Hold on. See, I can even do it going to the left. See what I mean? And I can do it going to the right. And then, like I said, with your walk backs, you can use this as a setup to get your defender to walk backwards. So let's say they're pressing you really hard to do a combo. So once you get the spin move, you can go like this. If they're a good defender, I mean, there's like two ways that the defender's gonna go when you do that move, when you do this. And this is just spin move R2 down. So it's basically this animation, but it's like the one you get after a spin move. You see what I mean? Like after I do a spin move, I get this animation. I get this animation. You get me? So hit him with a spin move, and now you're walking backwards to the hoop. And you can even spam it if you can time it. It's like one, two, spam, one, two. One, two, one, two. You see it? And that's just R2 flick down. So you can use this as a setup to get your player, you know, stepping backwards, which gives you room to just go crazy. You know what I mean? But yeah, that's pretty much all I have for this tutorial. Like I said, learn these dribble moves. Everything is muscle memory. Once you get them down, you can do them like second nature. Like, I actually can do them a lot smoother when I'm not explaining them. You know what I mean? When I'm explaining them, I'm thinking too much about how to do it. But when I'm playing the game, I just do them. I don't even think about it. And you will get there too. You know, you just gotta, you know, get into my court or one court and just practice these, and then, you know, take it into the online game. Man, it's just gonna become second nature muscle memory. But that being said, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button. If you hated this video, hit the dislike button. Tell me why. Maybe I suck at explaining things, and I could be in the comment section to explain or give more detail on what I was trying to teach you guys. Hit that subscribe button for more videos. I plan on dropping some gameplay of some, like, something on the PS5. Like, definitely I want to get y'all some 2K gameplay. You know, that new 2K looks sick. You know, I'm ready to go to the city. But you know, right now I don't have one, because like I said in the beginning of the video, I sold so bad, I don't have one right now. But yeah, hit that subscribe button, turn notifications on if you want to be first. You know what I'm saying? Leave a comment, leave a like, leave a dislike, do all the blah 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 blah, and I will see y'all out. Peace.